Dave Rankin was expecting them, as the remainder of the top assassins, which consist of Smoke, Dave, F. Tarkenton, and Maxwell Bishop. It was a fierce attack, and they shot and smashed their way into Rankin's safe house. As he was waiting for his men to finish them up, he got a surprise visit as Maxwell stealthily sneaks in without being detected by anyone into Rankin's room, whom immediately grabbed his gun and shot at an unexpected Maxwell, whom got hit on the arm as he fled and shot back at Rankin, but Rankin's shots got him. Confessing on how he used them to eradicate his competition, the Hyonis and Medamara, that the drone attack was meant for him and the rest of the gang. And with all his sinister plans, he was surprised that Maxwell came out alive. Even when he asked Fingerman to kill them all, they still escaped, and that he was impressed. F. Tarkenton and regular Dave have come to a dilemma, Taipan, as they have no choice but to face him head on. Legend have it that F. Tarkenton had once wrestled a bear to submission, but Taipan is no bear, as he pummeled and beat the living daylights out of him. Throughout the fight, the ass whooping, F. Tarkenton didn't lift a finger, and Dave was next. Now, the reason why Rankin went through all this trouble was because he wanted to be number one again. To Maxwell's amusement, confessing how he missed the number one spot, that he missed the number one spot so much it was like a dope fiend missing his next fix. He was never happy as the head of the crime family, for as a crime boss, it wasn't allowed for the head to be on the field. Basically, he missed killing. That was the worst thing that ever happened to him. You know, he was trying to make Maxwell Bishop understand his perspective. Dave only got one punch in the guts and he was down, as F. Tarkenton, awake from his slumber, rushed to attack Taipan, but again was met with another knockout punch. As Chad Fingerman was having the upper hand against Smoke, beating her to the floor and kicking her continuously, Taipan was done with Dave and F. Tarkenton as he ignited a grenade and dropped more grenade to the floor and jet out of the room, leaving them behind. And there was an explosion. Everyone noticed as Rankin told Maxwell that some of his friends are dead. In true confirmation, Taipan showed up and he ordered Taipan to go after a wounded Maxwell Bishop. As Taipan obeyed and was about to go for Maxwell, Rankin shot Taipan at the back of the head and he died. Happy that he got rid of the number one, he was very sure Fingerman will finish off Smoke, and when he gets here, he will kill him too. Rankin expressed his disgust at Maxwell that he never appreciated the number one spot like he does, for it was prestigious, and he has never met any former number one as dumb as Maxwell Bishop. That Maxwell Bishop is so stupid and dumb that he should have known that he killed his lover, and in all honesty, it was Maxwell he was aiming for in the first place. In anger, Maxwell tried to combat Rankin in shooting, but Rankin outsmarted him and gunned him down, almost killing him as usual. Rankin, in his dramatic ego, asked Maxwell how it feels not to be able to take vengeance for his lover's death. But more importantly, since he was nice enough to tell him his whole plan, he asked Maxwell Bishop what his own plan was. And Maxwell replied him, friendship. Right behind him and pointing a gun to his head was Smoke. He was surprised that Smoke overcame Fingerman due to the fact that Fingerman's ego couldn't let him see the bigger picture, for his arrogance got the better of him as he thought he was the fastest gun shooter. But Smoke was smarter, and without hesitation, Smoke killed him. Still pointing the gun to Rankin's temple, Smoke asked for permission to pull the trigger, and Maxwell gave his blessings, and that was the end of the enigmatic Dave Rankin. Surprisingly, regular Dave and F. Tarkenton survived the explosion due to the fact that they quickly hid in Rankin's panic room, and Smoke, knowing that she is number one, decided to take over the three gangs and became the street queen. Then Bishop was taken to the hospital, for he was injured badly. Lying in bed recovering, someone came to Maxwell Bishop talking about Smoke's success of merging the three crime family for her protection, but that Maxwell should deliver a message to her that there are more than 20 top killers in the world and they are coming for her.